Then what are the limitations of Rutherford model of atom? So the major limitation of Rutherford model is that it does not explain the stability of the atom, right? In Rutherford, it doesn't explain the stability of atom. And when charged bodies move in a circular motion, they emit radiation. This means that the atom revolving around the nucleus will lose energy and come closer and closer to the nucleus. And a stage will come when they will finally merge into the nucleus. This makes the atom unstable. The electron does not fall into the nucleus. Atoms are very stable to not collapse on their own. So this was the limitation of Rutherford. He said he didn't tell that, you know, whether the atoms are stable or not that. So this was the limitation. Then Bohr's model, very, very important. First of all, according to his, an atom consists of small positively charged nucleus at its center. Whole mass of atom is concentrated at the nucleus and volume of nucleus is smaller than the volume of atom. Proton and neutron of the atom are present in the nucleus. The electrons of the atom, which are negatively charged, revolve around the nucleus in definite circular path, right? And an orbit, as each orbit is associated with a fixed amount of energy, these orbits are also known as energy level. Then while revolving in discrete orbit, the electron do not radiate energy. When an electron jumps from one energy to another, the energy of the atom changes. So these were basically the observation you have to learn by heart. Okay. So let's just do it from here. Okay, and then just read it and let me know if you're not getting.
Done, ma'am.
डन
प्रमुख
Okay. Now let us do the next one, which is basically this. Over here, you have to compare all the proposed model of the atom in the given chapter. Okay. So this is very, very important. Read it in a very good way because you have only three models. One is Thomas model, one is Rutherford, one is Bohr's model. Okay. Read this quick. Okay, now the next question is, you have to summarize the rule of writing distribution of electron. Just read it, not the, you already know this, right? 2, 8, 18 and 32, this is the thing, right? Just read it once and then we will do define valency by an example. Okay, valency, how to find out the valency we already did, but we will define the next one. Just read it. This is how you define the, sorry, electron configuration in an atom.
Done, ma'am.
Okay, now coming to the next one, which is define valency and example. So valency is basically the capacity of an atom of an element, right? Either it will lose or it will gain, right? So silicon, its atomic number is 14. So this is the thing, the valency will be 4. So you will tell me for the valency of silicon and oxygen. Okay? You have your book. Just check the atomic number and accordingly work.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, Justine, check your answer. You got the valency for silicon is 4 and the valency of oxygen is 2. Right? Good. Now, this is the things which you need to learn, because if you will definitely get the, you can say this definition, right? So, atomic number, what is atomic number? What is mass number? What is isotopes and what are isobars? Very, very important. See, read it very carefully. Okay, then I'll leave. Very, very important. You have to by heart learn this definition with example, because for 1 or 2 marker, this will definitely come. It can come atomic number, it can be isotopes and isobars. High chances are there, but you should remember this. Or if you want to write it, you can write it.
Ma'am, can you like briefly explain what are isotopes and isobars?
Yes. Isotopes, basically over here, what is happening? The atoms which possess the same atomic number. Their atomic number is same, right? But their mass numbers are different. Right? For example, this H and H. Their atomic number are same, right? But their mass, see, it's 11 and it's 12. Right, so they are isotopes, that they have same atomic number but different atomic masses. And isobars, they have different, isobars are the atom of different element having same mass number but different atomic number, right? So they have same mass but their atomic number is different. They have different atomic masses but they have same atomic number. This is the only difference. Clear?
Okay, ma'am.
You have to learn the uses of isotopes, like isotopes of uranium is used in fuel of nuclear reactor, and isotopes of cobalt is used in the treatment of cancer. Very, very important for one marker as well, for one word as well.